So as we all know, Mars is currently a hot topic, or rather a cold one. So our team is focusing on the strategies of radiation protection. I'm particularly working on passive shielding. Tammy is focusing on active shielding, and Julia's work is on Martian habitats. Our main motivation for this project is that space radiation is a huge problem for astronauts, especially when they're outside the Earth's protection. So we really need to find ways to protect astronauts from this radiation, especially for during long duration missions, as main goal is to make a stable and safe life on Mars. So talking about passive shielding, it involves sufficient use of material, in fact, to absorb energy from cosmic radiation. The main materials that we can ask for are polyethylene, graphite, aluminium, copper, and water. So there are certain criteria to compare these materials, namely most electrons per unit mass, the mean excitation energy, tight binding conditions, and also shielding effectiveness. So while comparing all the materials based on this criteria, we found out that hydrogen is highly effective. So since polyethylene has two molecules of hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen in per molecule, so it is the most convenient material. It reduces the dose by 21% to 31% depending on the target depth. Currently, polyethylene is being used in the sleeping quarters as well as in the galleries in ISS. Now, switching off to the next topic, active shielding. Active shielding is basically like a mobile magnetosphere. The ISS is currently using a superconducting magnet, namely AMS-02, which is a big magnet. But its main purpose is not to protect from radiation, but to find out about different kinds of radiation which ISS encounters. One of the variations which was developed by AMS collaboration team was double helix. It reduces the dose by 40 to 60%. So it makes Mars as safe as ISS is for the astronauts. So this is a design of the double helix. And it has 12 magnetic coils that have a diameter of around 2 meters, and it would be 18 meters long. Switching off to Martian habitats. We all know Mars has a very thin atmosphere. So we said, and transporting construction materials from Earth would be very, very risky. And of course, very costly as well. So the most promising solution would be to use in-situ resources. Now there can be two types of habitat on Mars. It can be on surface, it can be under surface as well. So talking about on surface, we can use a water-rich regolith mixture, which prevents radiation very effectively. But it can also create secondary radiations. So to counter that, we can add polymer binds to the mixture to make us an easy habitat for the astronauts. Now there can be a psychological problem with the astronauts because they are habitual of living on Earth. But since because of the atmosphere of Mars, we simply can't have windows on the habitat. Now talking about the other type of surface, other habitat. I'm sorry for the glitch. So talking about undersurface habitat. So in the northernmost regions of Mars, we have found caves and lava tubes, which can be used to make 20 meter thick roofs. Now astronauts will have a psychological effect on them because they need to feel really safe as they're under the surface. There would be like dozens of meters of rock layers above their head. So they really need to convincing that they'll be safe under the surface. Now this is a picture of Martian habitats. The first one shows the above surface habitats and the other one is the below surface habitat. Now conclusion of our outcome, we can say that there are many risks for Mars missions and one of them is radiation. So this study is just a step forward. There can never be a single solution to that. In future, we can apply a combination of all these techniques to have a better radiation protection, and we can apply all these techniques in all other manned missions as well. It can be moon missions or it can be the exploring space systems as well. We all know that new technology takes birth every moment and every day. Thank you.
Thank you, Shireen. Does anybody have any questions for Shireen? Don't be shy. I see a question from Ishani, who asks, could you please explain a bit more about the double helix?
Okay, so double helix is basically a supermagnet designed by the AMS collaboration team. So it is bigger in size, and there can be different variations of double helix. So if you in lower targets, it can reduce the radiation by 20% or 40%, or in bigger targets, it can reduce the radiation by 60%. So currently, it's still in process of invention.
Thank you. If you were in charge of designing the spacesuits of astronauts on Mars, how would you make them different than the current spacesuits that astronauts on ISS are wearing?
Well, my main motive would be to make it as lightweight as possible, because I have noticed that astronaut suits are really heavy. So even though I don't have any experience, but I feel that astronauts, like how, like when Steve was talking, what I felt was that astronauts feel really heavy. It's really difficult for them to even do their regular activities. Like they can't even scratch their heads. They even were sneezing. They have to turn their heads somewhere else so that it doesn't come on the screen. I think that, and they're feeling so much weight on their body. They can't bend down easily. So I think my main motive would be to, no matter what material I use, it should be lightweight enough so that astronauts are comfortable wearing that, because they simply can't remove their spacesuits there when they're constantly wearing it all the time throughout the missions, unless they are in International Space Station, of course. But I think on Mars mission, they would have to wear it constantly, like all the time. So I think I'll try to make it as lightweight as possible.